My name is Olga Zvilinska, and today I'm showing you the teddy bear on a toy poodle. So what we need small curve scissors, we need sinners, we need curved chunkers or straight chunkers, and if you want to use clipper, you can use clipper, but I usually do heads with my scissors. So this is small scissors, Velita Calibri, and this is 32 teeth blender, so it's my line Zulita. First I'm cleaning stop area. Short, just slightly open tip of the scissors and clean it. So it's very clean here. Then I want to cut a little bit of the chin area with curved chunkers to the Adam apple. Then I'm holding comb first, and you use your scissors this way and go against the gravity. You're going up in front of the ears. You can hold the ear, and under the ears you chop it off everything. We need air flow under the ear, so we just avoid the ear infections. So very round, chop, chop, chop. Comb out, comb up, continue to work in front of the head, curve line, knit rounder. You can use your three fingers on the opposite hand, so thumb and point, we're going mustache and beard this way, and the middle finger under, so support the chin, prevent to open mouth, and the dog feels secure. So very curved, nice line around. Then I will work with the mustache. Comb up on the sides. You can use the same chunkers or use small curved scissors, and from the side of the muzzle, go to the middle of the muzzle. This bulk in front of the ear you can take with the singing shears. It's okay, baby. Good boy. Comb again. You can use your curved scissors on slight angle here. If you have problem with the tear staining on your dog, you can use the same small chunk singing shears and cut a little bit of the corner of the eye. So just don't make it bald, and I'd never use clippers there because clippers sometimes cause irritation. We want to avoid irritation. Hold the mustache and beard the same way. Like that. I don't press on the top of the muzzle because that's the nostrils and they want to breathe, and if you push it down, they feel uncomfortable. They always try to move the head. So always mustache, beard, and a finger under. Good boy. Good boy. Comb up. Be careful and chop off in front of the muzzle. We don't need that huge mustache that going in a water bowl. And we don't need that beard. We want dog look younger. So shorter on the chin and rounder. What's to do with that part that hanging same like on Bichons? You can use the thin shears and blend it around. And then comb again and blend more. Comb mustache up and blend toward ear. Thin shears or blenders, it's for final steps. So just make that face more natural looking and more finished, more precise. So this way, now I will work on the forehead. I comb one layer above the eyebrows area, comb down. I will use my small scissors and scissor it to the middle of the eye. Then I twist my scissors and groom down to the corner of the eye. So it's kind of infinity line. You can clean again in front of the nose, I'm sorry, eyes, and then twist your scissors and go to the corner of the eyes. Then second layer. Now you can use your curve chunkers or curve scissors. You can use curve scissors, no problem if you don't like chunkers. And use your curve, blend to the sides. Then comb up and find the length of the top. So for me, the middle of the face, it will be on the top area. So actually, it's almost the same part and same like a diameter here, not diameter, the radius here. So that's the middle of the circle, that's the radius. So you're going again from bottom to the top, looking on a mustache. You know, the good trick, if you grooming with the scissors, you can put your comb on a stop area and you will see symmetry. Same you can put here and you can see symmetry. It's help a lot. So put your comb on a stop area and you will see the length between bottom side, between the comb and a bottom line and a top line. So you will see how big and how small. And again, clean, blend. Try to make ideal circle. Check with your comb, up, fluff. You'll see the corner coming out. You need to take it off. Again, against the gravity to hold the coat in a nice direction. That technique will help you a lot. If you're going down, you always push the hair, so you actually fight with the hair. This way, you just hold it up, and it's easy to scissor. So it's rounded now. Now we work on the ear. I use Artera Mix spray. That's my scissoring spray. It's helped to get rid of static, and it's also to hold that ears completely in nice shape. Scissor the ears, slightly angled. Try to use only one cut, then avoid all these lines. And then you can turn the head on 90 degrees and use your curved chunkers, hold the ear, and clean everything behind the ear. Blend to the neckline. Okay, pull the head down, comb up, and here finish above the occiput. That area is called occiput. Fluff again. If it's a little bit too high top knot, you can scissor more. No squarish sides, so we try to clean it. Hold the ear again, clean under, really good, under the ear. Come down. And blend. Fluff, fluff, fluff. And you see, check, everything should be even. Everything should be in your circle. Short chin. No sticking out. Mustache, it should be curved, round, always inside the circle line. So now you see on that area, it's after, that is before, so you will see how different. It's very nice curved finish, round, and this one was before. So look at that. Okay? So that's my teddy bear. Thank you for watching.